Hey guys, what's up? It's me, Jang here, and welcome to episode 48 of Let's Play Kingdom Hearts Final Mix. On the last episode, we got to basically where the final boss is, and we're gonna go and take it on today. So yeah, I picked the perfect day to do it too. I've been out all day, I had 2 hours of sleep last night, and I'm exhausted. So I'm gonna be a little bit loopy, and yeah, it's gonna be a fun experience, guys. So, huh? What's wrong? Don't you hear something? There. What do you hear, Sora?
Careful. This is the last haven you'll find here. Beyond, there is no light to protect you. But don't be afraid. Your heart is the mightiest weapon of all. Remember, you are the one who will open the door to the light.
Go on. Controller. That controller's being weird. Go on!
Oh, there we go. Alright, it's on. I don't know what the hell that was. But anyways, let's go. I don't hear anything. Strange. That voice was so familiar. Maybe it's just my imagination.
Maybe you better take a rest.
Yeah, Sora, take a rest. You clearly hallucinated. But you know, whatever. We gotta open the door and, here we go, guys. The beginning of the end. Indeed. Quite indeed. This is, it's gonna be quite the experience. Oh, look where we are. We're back at Destiny Islands. My home. My island. We're here. What next?
Is this my island?
Yep. Definitely not fake at all, because, you know, this is realistic and stuff. So, oh, yeah, there was a bridge there 2 seconds ago, and then now it's not. Honestly, I don't remember where we're supposed to go. Oh, we can't even go over there, so that's cool, I guess. I assume we go towards the secret place, maybe? Maybe not. Or maybe we do. Hold on, let's go. Let's go. Maybe there's something interesting. Oh, yep, this looks about right.
This world has been connected.
What?
What was that?
I agree!
Tied to the darkness.
Darkness.
Soon to be completely eclipsed.
Nah, man.
There is so very much to learn.
Sounds very familiar.
You understand so little.
It's almost like we heard this in the beginning.
A meaningless effort. One who knows nothing can understand nothing.
That was my high school quote in senior year. In the yearbook. Good for me, right? I don't know why I did that, but I appreciate that fact now. I just wanted to be random. And yeah, so Destiny Islands doesn't look like it's doing too great, huh? Just full of darkness cracks all over the place. Oh, and we got a little Riku over there. Riku, you good, fam? We good to hang out? Also, I don't know what's going on the floor, but I guess it's sparkling, so let's take this on. We'll be okay, right? 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 Hey, Riku, how you doing?
Take a look at this tiny place.
Yeah? What about it?
To the heart-seeking freedom, this island is a prison, surrounded by water.
Yep.
And so this boy sought out to escape from his prison. He sought a way to cross over into other worlds.
And he did, didn't he?
And he opened his heart to darkness.
Well, I do suppose that's true. Oh. You're not Riku. Oh.
Don't bother. Your voice can no longer reach him where he is.
It's not true.
His heart belongs again to darkness.
I don't believe you.
All worlds begin in darkness. And all so end. The heart is no different. Darkness sprouts within it. It grows, consumes it.
Does it?
Such is its nature.
I'm sure.
In the end, every heart returns to the darkness whence it came. You see, darkness is the heart's true essence.
If you say
so,
man.
The heart may be weak, and sometimes it may even give in. But I've learned that deep down there's a light that never goes out.
It's one of my favorite quotes too, right there. What are you gonna do, Ansem? Huh? We're gonna fight?
So you have come this far, and still you understand nothing.
That's what you think.
Every light must fade. Every heart return to darkness.
I don't want to. I was a heartless once. And yeah, there's that guardian dude, so ooh, let's go with this fight. Let's see how we can do. Oh, I don't remember this fight at all, actually. You know, I'm gonna arrow just in case. Also, we took a crap ton of damage out of him. So this won't be too difficult. Let's go in. Oh, no, fuck you and your Hung Guardian. Alright, we still got you. We got you behind. Also, you're already almost a full bar down, which is pretty good. Alright, we deflected that by accident, but you know what? It still happened. Alright, Hung Guardian, I'm gonna go up. I'm trying to go behind you, bro. There we go. I forgot we have Super Glide. We have not even used it yet, I'm pretty sure. Also, I don't remember the battle ever going in this part of the arena. Oh, geez. Aeroga, I suppose. Alright, down to two. This is actually really anticlimactic, and, I remember what happens in this battle, so I'm expecting, like, you know, this is gonna be somewhat smooth, hopefully, maybe. Also, I don't remember, I did equip items on the last episode, or one of the recent episodes. I put a bunch of elixirs, and I think one ether, which, I guess will do the job, I suppose. Come on. We got you down to 1.5 bars, so let's keep going. No! Oh, did you attack Donald? I don't even, alright, well, whatever. I'm gonna stay safe, do a little Aeroga. I'm gonna heal. Still doing alright. We're on to almost the last bar. Looks like we're pretty, nope, not quite, actually. Alright, now we're in the last bar. Alright, just a little bit left to go. Doing good. Let's see. We're like speedrunning statics, except not at all, because I'm too trash at this game to ever speedrun. Actually, too trash at pretty much any game to speedrun anything, so, yeah. We're almost there, Let's go. Ansem, there we go. Got a 10,000 experience out of that, I'm pretty sure that's what it said. And, yeah, motion blur, all that kind of stuff. Ansem, you're dead. Completely dead. No way of returning now. Right. Oh. It's like some stuff's going on with the island, huh? Yeah, some stuff's going on with the island. Boo. Poor island. You know, we were just coming back home, and, you know, we wanted to, you know, be okay. So anyways, yep. As you could tell, probably, in case you haven't played this before, there's another phase to fighting Ansem. That was not the final boss itself. If that was, that would be very anticlimactic. Crap. Can I use items here? Do I have one of those, like, cottage things? Yes, I do. Yeah, let's use a cottage, since we don't use them for anything else. We have, like, 11 of them, so why not? Let's go. We have some more cutscenes coming our way. It's gonna be a lengthy episode. Oh, Donald and Goofy are out. It's like it's all on us. We can do it. We can take him. Oh, I forgot that this was a part of the boss. We have to fight Gigantic Heartless. What's it called again? Oh, God. This is going to... I should know this. I really should know this. Oh, God. I feel like an awful Kingdom Hearts fan because I do not know the name of this fucking Heartless. What is it called? Jesus Christ. I don't remember. This is going to... just ruined me. I don't know why I'm blanking out right now, because, oh my God, what is this called? I remember the Twilight Thorn, but what's this called? I feel like it's something really not that difficult. It's gonna bother me so much. Bro, could you just, bring a hand down or something? That works. Alright. Nope. Oh, jeez. You got me. Good for you. You're doing pretty good. Whatever the hell your name is, I can't remember. I don't know why I can't remember. This is horrible. All right. Also, we got some strength. What the hell is this thing called? Oh my God. Once I find out what it is, I'm gonna like freak out and be like, what the fuck? I really forgot this. Oh God. All right. Well, that's done. It was not difficult at all as it ever was. It was never very difficult. Did I die to that thing? I don't remember. What the hell is it called? This is. I don't remember. I'll look. At some point, it's gonna bother me. All right, wind. All right, so you only got 4 bars now this time. So maybe we'll make some clean work of you. Although we don't have Donald and Goofy this time, so we won't be as well equipped. But whatever. That's fine. We already took you down half a bar. That's still something. All right, stop, Hung Guardian asshole motherfucker, dude. I've had enough of you. I have enough of your nonsense. All right, we took him down 1 bar. God, this is. This ain't a great. Oh no! This is not a great display of your skills, Ansem. So, ooh, I got you with Aeroga. I also just don't know what just happened. I think. Oh, am I blocking his attack? That's pretty dope. Alright, so we got him down a bar and a half, and we're still hitting him, even though he's using that Hung Guardian ass stuff. Okay, we're still hanging. Oh, I don't remember what this is, so this is probably gonna be really bad. Nope, not like that. Do not like this. Do not like this. It looks like he's probably invisible during this phase, although this is not that difficult to dodge so far. Oh, I don't have any MP. That's why I was like, why can't I use arrow right now? Oh, geez. Stop it. Don't do that. I'm trying to... No, Hung Guardian. And that's bad. That's real bad. All right. Answer them. Almost down to his last bar. That's all good with me. No, nope, not taking anything. Not taking any of your shit, Ansem. That's right, we're almost down to your last bar. No, fuck you. No, get out of here. Trying to end this in a decently short amount of time, or a decent length episode, so it's not like hours long. I'm gonna use an ether, I guess, because I forgot that the first slot was an ether and not an elixir, so that's good. Because I don't think I really need an elixir, but an ether's pretty good, I suppose. Alright, and we dodged that somehow by accident. I love how both times dodged that by accident. Also, stop. Stop, Hung Guardian. Nah. Alright, answer me on your last bar, halfway through. We're putting in the work. Hung Guardian, don't you dare. Don't you dare. I said don't you dare. No. Okay, I'm gonna heal. Because that's a good time to heal. Also, I forgot that I don't have a second chance on. I remembered I was going to do that, but I completely forgot that I was going to. Oh, jeez. And... No. There he is. All right, we got max HP, and I remember we leveled up earlier during the other battle. I think we got strength up, something like that. I don't remember. Whew, well, you know, it doesn't matter. Oh, not to bump the mic pedestal thing. That's not good. Not good at all. Huh, what do you got for me now, Ansem? Got more tricks up your sleeve? Got more Hung Guardians? Oh, Goofy! Sora! What? Yeah? Donald!
Behold the endless abyss. Within it lies the heart of all worlds.
Is it Kingdom Hearts?
Kingdom Hearts!
I'm like a psychic or something. It's like a new.
Look as hard as you are able. You'll not find even the smallest glimmer of light.
I'm sure.
From those dark depths are all hearts born. Even yours.
I doubt that. Because I'm Sora, Keyblade Master.
Darkness conquers all worlds!
But like, seriously, where did this even come from? Like, why? Like, where did he come up and, like, just make all this? Like, where did this all come from? Did he build this while he was Riku and we were... This is what Riku was really building when he said he was working on the raft. He was just building this giant-ass, heartless boat thing. Also, we're falling, because apparently we can't fly. Whoa, Donald and Goofy! What do? We fly, right? We just gotta believe.
Giving up already? Come on, Sora. I thought you were stronger than that.
It's one of my favorite quotes, too. My boy Riku. Come on, Sora. You can survive. There you go. That's a ticket. More flying. You know, my favorite part of Kingdom Hearts 1 combat, just being able to fly and or Atlantica combat. You know, it's the same thing. So anyway, he looks livid. Okay, let's go. Ready, Ansem? Ready to catch these hands, fam? Because I'm going to give them. All right. Okay. Oh, ow, ouch. Alright, Ansem! Oh no. Alright, heal. Good thing I got Leaf Bracer. At least I have Leaf Bracer on. And we took him down a bar already, actually. Actually, we gotta take him down this entire thing before we move on to the next phase, right? I don't remember this boss very well. It's not very particularly memorable to me because it's a flying level and those are not that fun to me because I hate all the combat that has to do with flying because it just horribly affects the entire battle because I can't block, I'm pretty sure, right? Yeah, I can't block. Also, I like how that's pretty much like Riku's weapon right there, the Soul Eater. That's what it's called? Yeah, the Soul Eater. I'm still trying to think about what that name of the giant heartless is. I can't remember. I'll figure it out. Alright, so that's one phase of this boss done. This is actually proven to be not too difficult, but I think I might have... Maybe it was a mistake to do all the freaking cups first, because I think that leveled us up way too much. Well, at least we're making good time, because I do have places to be after this episode. I'm going to go see Batman vs. Superman, which I do not have high hopes for at all. I'm going with Kevin and his girlfriend, and I think it'll be a fun time, but like I said, probably not going to be that great of a movie. I'm not expecting much. And let's fight all these shadows. Let me know if you guys have seen the movie yet, because by the time this video goes up, the movie will have been out for like a week or something, I think, probably. I don't remember even when it came out. I'm pretty sure it came out like on Friday. Today's Sunday, just for the reference. Let me just collect some HP ores. Let me just heal while you're trying to find me, Mr. Shadow Heartless. All right, we got him. All right, and what do we do? Oh yeah, we attacked this, right? And that's it, I think, right? And now we get a party member, I think? I mean, I like the concept behind this boss. It was definitely great for its time, I think. But now, I think it's kind of like, Kingdom Hearts 2, I think, did a lot better job. But I mean, Kingdom Hearts 2 also did come a few years later. So, I'm sure, and as far as my opinion goes, I think Kingdom Hearts 2 improved upon Kingdom Hearts 1 in pretty much every way. Not every way, but pretty much every way. That's just my thought. Also, I don't remember what I have to do in this part, but I'm going to use some arrow. I'm pretty sure I have to defeat these things. Let's do that real quick. All right, let's defeat darkness penises, I think, I guess. I don't know what else to call them. I mean, there's plenty of other things I could call them. Also, I'm glad that Iroga deflects all these little beams, because that makes life a lot nicer. All right, and we're getting rid of all these, and awkward transition right there. So that's those, and does that mean we have to go into that? Is that what happens? Let's go, let's try it. Alright, Portal of Darkness, nice, not ominous at all. Sora! Alright, so we got Goofy, nice. We have a party member, which is always good to have, and I like Goofy in general as a party member and just as a character in general. I like Donald too, just not as much as a party member, you know. I like him as a character. He's a little weird and greedy and sometimes a little selfish and all that kind of stuff. It makes him a little funny, and then Goofy's just, you know, the kind-hearted, happy-go-lucky kind of guy who fights with a shield. One of the few people out there to fight with a shield. He's, you know, if you fight it with a shield, you're pretty badass. Let's take care of these Heartless Goofy. Is that all of them? Yep, that is all of them. We are killing it right now. So that's that. That thing's destroyed. And slow motion again? Yep, slow motion. Cool. We're just breezing through this boss. Let's see what we got for time right now. Oh yeah, we are breezing through this. This is great. This is gonna be a longish episode, but you know, nothing too terribly long like it could have been. I can only imagine if I kept dying during this part, that would just be rough. Alright, let's go, Goofy. It's just me and you. Let's go. Alright, I gotta fight this thing. We're just giving it the hands. Just gonna go in and battle. We're already almost done with one bar. Also, I'm gonna heal because I have Leaf Razor and it's fine. And, you know, all that kind of stuff. We're just going in. Goofy, you did a good job, I suppose. But if you could wake up, I believe you have second wind. So that'd be great if you could do that. Also, I use Cure at the right time, because that was right when lightning was about to hit me, and then I healed and didn't get hit by it. Alright, Goofy, you're gonna wake up anytime soon. You got some MP in you, and you know what, it's fine. This guy's almost dead. By the time you get up, he's gonna be dead. Alright, he's dead. And Goofy wakes up. Of course, that's how it happens. Goofy, he's already dead. You don't have to do anything. You're good. You're good, son. You're good. You did your work. And I appreciate, you know, the job that you did, but I had to do most of the work, Goofy. Come on. Alright, into another Portal of Darkness. Oh, let's ignore all that nonsense. Alright, does that mean we have Donald? Alright, we got Donald, and of course, I don't know what that is. Oh, Mega Potion, that's not what I want. Elixir, alright, and I don't even care about all the items that we're wasting, because this is the end of the game. Doesn't even matter. It's all good in the neighborhood. Alright, so let's get rid of all these invisibles, which are quite invisible in this darkness, so I guess the name is quite fitting. Alright, just die. I can't see what's going on. I'm literally just kind of mashing X right now. Not really any rhyme or reason for it. Invisible, there we go. I can't see you. Oh, there we go. There you are. Thank you, Donald. You put in the word so I can see everybody. And that should be it. Yep, alright, let's go after this thing. Yeah, duh, duh. There we go. More shit. Just more shit going on in the world of Kingdom Hearts. You know, what else is new? Nothing new. That's what's new. Getting through these phases rather quickly. What else is left? I don't remember, to be perfectly honest. I think we're getting close, though. Just came out of that dude's mouth. Nothing weird there. Just, that's gonna explode, right? Because we filled it with liquid nitrogen and it exploded. I don't know if that's what liquid nitrogen does, but it looked like it could have been. He froze and died, so yeah. Now we gotta go. Oh, yep, I remember this part. We gotta attack the heart thing with a face. It's kind of bulbous and disgusting, but you know what? It's all good. It's all good. We don't discriminate here on my channel. We appreciate everybody and everything. As long as you're not evil. Although this thing is probably evil, so maybe we don't appreciate it after all. Alright, let's just get rid of these because, you know, I want to. They're a little fucking annoying. Alright, and you're dead. Can I attack you? Are you a thing? Nope. Is there, what? You know what would be cool? There was like a treasure chest just chilling back here. And it would be like the worst thing ever because you wouldn't be able to attack or be able to get it because, you know, the whole you can't open things while you're. Oh, that's gonna explode. Yep. Or you can't open, treasure chest during battle, so that would just blow. That'd be kind of funny though. I'd appreciate that. And then there's like some hidden item and someone like hacks the game or mods it or whatever and like is able to get that item out as like this like ridiculous keyblade. That'd be a really cool Easter egg. Alright, Ansem. I think that means we have to take you on again. So let's do it. You got your Soul Eater spear, Darth Maul ass fucking shit. And we're ready to take you on. Alright, so I see your beams are back. That's fine, I suppose. We'll just fight through it. I don't care. I give no shits right now. Alright, shut up with you in the darkness. I don't know what you're talking about, but I'm just gonna attack you, because we're almost down. You're almost down 2 bars. You are down 2 bars. Now you're down 2.5, and you're gonna be down 3 in a second. Oh, jeez. Stop. I don't know what's going on. I can't, like, get close to him. Alright, heal. I got Aeroga on. Alright, we're back. Okay, now we're down to your last 2 bars. 1.5 bars, I suppose. I'm gonna heal, actually. Just right there, because I thought it would be a good time. Alright, and you got 0.5 bar left, and you're almost dead, and I'm gonna heal again, just in case. And there we go! And we got Treasure Magnet, and that's exactly what we need for this battle right now. So, you're dead. Is there any phases left? I don't remember. But looks like Ansem took quite a hit, and so did the ship that Riku built in the beginning of the game. Looks like bad stuff's going on, right? Right, guys? Ansem, you're turning into light. You okay, man? You doing good? You need some, like, water? Medical assistance? How about a shot of vodka? But cure whatever ails you? You know, alcohol's not the answer, kids. Alcohol is never the answer. It can be a solution. I don't know if that's actually correct. It might be, maybe. Don't listen to me for science facts. It's probably wrong. Yeah.
It is futile. The Keyblade alone cannot seal the door to darkness.
That's what you think.
Kingdom Hearts, fill me with the power of darkness.
Alright, Kingdom Hearts, do your shit. Fill them with darkness. That sounds awful and dirty. Don't take it the wrong way. Yeah.
Supreme darkness.
Oh no, Kingdom Hearts.
I know now.
Without a doubt. Kingdom Hearts is light.
Oh, I had the timing a little bit off. But, you know, I knew the line. It's one of my favorite parts of the game, too. I love the end of this game. I won't lie. I don't remember the boss necessarily that well, but I like the cutscenes. Also, Ansem, looks like you're being affected by the light, and it doesn't look like you're doing very good. Maybe you should have taken that medical assistance I offered earlier. Maybe. Or would you have listened to me if I was a little bit more British? I don't know why I'd be British at all. It's not even a good British accent. You guys got this. All you need is the voice of British Meat Shying. I don't know why I've been doing this recently.
Stop scaring that big Russian.
Yeah, Goofy.
Huh?
Donald, what you doing now? Aw, shoot.
Heartless.
Yep. I agree.
Don't give up.
Riku!
Come on, Sora. Together we can do it.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, prepubescent Haley Joel Osment. You did an okay job. An okay job, at best, I would say. But I guess, voice acting in general, wasn't... God, I feel like the name of that thing coming back to me. What is it? God, I'm not gonna remember it, am I? I don't know why I'm not remembering. Oh! Huh? Who's that?
Majesty.
The king!
Now, Sora, let's close this door for good.
Okay.
But...
Don't worry. There will always be a door to the light.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
Sora, you can trust King Mickey.
Now, they're coming.
Donald, Goofy, thank you.
You're welcome. We did our job. He didn't even thank Sora. What a fucking asshole.
Take care of her.
I will. I think. Maybe. Sora, you got this. See you, Riku. It's still bothering me what the hell the name of that frickin' Heartless is. I like how that's what I'm fixating on during the end of this game. Guys, can you believe it? We're at the end of the game. That's nuts. I mean, it's not the end of the Let's Play, but it's the end of the game. It's just... Man, this has been a hell of a journey, guys. And a journey that... I'm really happy that we made. And, again, love the music in this game. Warms my heart. The island is back to normal, maybe. Or nope, just a flashback. I actually don't remember if this was in the original game or not, to be perfectly honest. It's been a while. Like I said, I didn't play all the way through Kingdom Hearts 1 often. I usually stopped at Atlantica because I was tired of the shit. Oh, Kyrie and your awkward laugh. Memories with friends. How adorable. So now what, guys? It's Kairi! Haven't said that in a while. Kairi! Why you look so sad, Kairi? Oh no. He's gonna get lost and never see Donald and Goofy ever again. He didn't even say goodbye. Sora, what a prick. I understand you after your girl, but... Damn. Oh, I love the ending of this game.
Sora! Kairi! Remember what you said before? I'm always with you too. I'll come back to you. I promise! I know you will!
Still don't know why he didn't just, you know, run over a little bit faster. I understand that, you know, there's still stuff to do, but he doesn't know that. Ooh. You know, like, looking at it now, like, I don't know why I love this cutscene so much, or just the end of this game so much, but I do. I just do. The island's coming back to life. You know, I almost did a face cam just for this episode, but, kinda glad that I didn't. I'm not tearing up, you're tearing up. This isn't a super great ending or anything like that. You guys are crazy. Completely crazy. I'm not crying, you're crying. It's fine though, I'm good. I held it back. And all the worlds are coming back. I don't know if I'm ruining this, the end of this game with my voice, but I just can't help but talk, because I need to, you know? I just love this franchise so much. It still looks so pretty in HD too. Just in general. It looked pretty back then, looks pretty now. Maybe a little blocky, but you know what can you do? They still look great. Like, if Kingdom Hearts 3 just looked like this, that would have been cool. Alright guys, I didn't make it. Ah, god, the tears are just coming out. This game is just my childhood, man. Oh god, that is the end of Kingdom Hearts, guys. I swear to god, I thought I could hold it together. I've seen this ending quite a few times, just the cutscene, because I just like to watch the ending cutscene of this game, and I don't know, for some reason it's like one of the few games that really just gets to me. I know it's gotta be related to nostalgia or something, because I know I was not like, I didn't do this the first time I played the game. I remember it was only like when I played it years later again, I was just like, wow, this really brings me back. And this is, it reminds me of why, you know, I really love this series so much. Like, yeah, and it marks the end of at least the beginning of the end of the first Let's Play I ever did. It's been really cool to do it for you guys, and I really hope that you guys enjoyed the journey with me and my stupidity, and, you know, Danny DeVito there, and almost Hercules. Yoko Shimomura too, you were one of my big inspirations as a musician, and maybe one day I'll be able to do the soundtrack of a video game myself, and that's ultimately what I hope and aim to do. Along with, you know, all sorts of different products or projects, because, you know, I want to keep doing YouTube for a while, see how this goes, and, you know, maybe it could become something. I'm pretty happy with the way things have been going, and, yeah, it's been hell of a journey, guys. I've been, you know, through all sorts of different moods doing YouTube, you know, like, happy with all the positive feedback, you know, frustrated with the fact that I'm not, you know, getting videos out for you guys when I want to necessarily, and just all that stuff. I also thought this was a lot longer. I'm sure there's more. Yeah, there is more, I remember. So yeah, let's, gotta let the credits play, because, you know, it's all the people that worked on this game. Yeah, like I said, there's very few games that make me feel emotional like this. This being one of them. And, the other games actually being the Pokemon freaking Mystery Dungeon games, because I really liked just the story of, especially the second one. The third one was eh, but it still made me, you know, I was sobbing at the end of that game. I remember it was back when I was in college, sophomore year. I was living with Kevin, and I was playing this game at like 2 in the morning, and I'm just like, and Kevin's passed the fuck out in his bed, and I'm just like trying so hard not to like sob audibly. I was like ridiculously upset when I was playing Gates to Infinity, which, like I said, was not a great game, not one of my favorites, but Still got to me. And good to see that Pinocchio is a real boy now. I should actually start commenting on all the stuff going on the screen, right? Besides, you know, talking about myself. Nice, Aladdin and Jasmine kiss. See if Sora and Kyrie ever kiss. Honestly, I'm gonna put out my opinion right now. I couldn't care either way. It'd be cool to see, because, like, you know, it's something that they've been building up for. But at the same time, I don't really care. I really don't care. Because the relationship between Sora and Kyrie romantically is not super important to me. I just... Even though I just teared up at them freaking, like, being sad over not being able to see each other, I know I'm a fucking hypocrite. Whatever. I don't know what I'm even talking about, guys. Like I said, I only got 2 hours of sleep last night. I've been out all day, and I got places to be tonight. Maybe that's all that stuff is affecting me. I'm also being very visually stimulizing. What the hell am I talking about? Even though there's no camera in front of me, I feel like I am talking to a camera, because I don't know. I just love being able to, you know, talk to you guys who are, you know, listening to me and staying here to support me, and I'm just really happy that you guys found me and watched my videos. It's really, honestly, an honor and humbling just to, I don't know, see that people appreciate, you know, what I'm doing, because I really do, in the end of the day, I really do just want to, you know, help people out, make people entertained, keep people, you know, going, and motivate them to, you know, just know that they shouldn't give up ever, and just, you know, as long as you're motivated, you're dedicated towards working to something that you really care about, then you're gonna go somewhere, and that's what I really believe, and that's why I'm still here, you know, through all the random YouTube stuff, because it's, you know, it is really hard to, you know, keep going when, you know, you're just, you know, starting out, because, you know, nobody knows you, you're just making these videos, and hopefully someone checks it out, and that's where I am, and... Yeah, it's been a hard ride, but you know what? I think a very rewarding one, because I get to hear from you guys, and you guys make it 100% worth it. And I hope you guys know that. I like to make sure that you guys remember that I care about you guys, and I want... And it really makes me happy that you guys are here, you know, supporting me, watching these videos, and talking to me, because it's nice. And I want to talk to you guys too. That's why I try to make sure that I respond to every comment, that every person is heard, because I want to be that person to listen and all that stuff. I know I'm probably rambling about a bunch of nonsense right now, but you know what? It's true. It really is. And yeah, it's the end of my first Let's Play. I mean, I've ended other Let's Plays in the past, but it's not the same as the first one that I started. The first episode of this Let's Play was the fourth video on my channel, and now, 100-something videos later, here's the beginning of the end. All we have left are the secret bosses. Yeah, we just beat the final boss. It's going through my mind right now, and yeah, thanks to Disney and Square Enix for making this game. It's really, really nice, and there's Kingdom Hearts Final Mix. That was it, guys. Mostly. We still got secret bosses to go through, but, you know... Oh, I forgot about this. We got some more cutscenes. Oh, boy. Sora down Goofy with different clothes for whatever reason. Don't know why. Just happened, you know. I always question this. Never made sense to me. It's a good question, Donald.
We've got to find Riku and King Mickey.
But, where do we start looking for that there door to the light?
Huh?
Huh? Ah. Ah. Solid voice acting. Hey, it's Pluto.
Pluto?
Pluto?
Hey, Pluto. Where have you been?
Where's that? Huh? They got a letter.
Of course, that's the King's seal.
With the King's seal.
Hey.
Have you seen King Mickey?
Yeah, buddy. Come follow me. I won't lead you to some ominous area where you might...
Guys, let's go!
Where you might be in great danger. Sora, you fucking interrupting me. And, there they go, guys. Goofy with his goofy-ass run. Donald with his Donaldness. And Sora with his big-ass shoes. And Pluto with his letter. Man. This game, man, just gives me the feels, yo. It's just... I remember the first time when I played this game, I was like, oh.
Remember, Sora, you are the one who will open the doors of the light.
Well, like I said, yeah, this game is, you know, meant a lot to me when I first played it. I loved it the second I picked it up. I did not put it down. I played it for a week straight. I did not sleep. I went to school, and it was, remember, it was during soccer season and football season, because I played both. Oh, shoot, secret movie. Stuff's going on. Oh, God, stop. Don't do this to me. I've had enough tears today, guys. Just stop putting all these nice cutscenes in front of me.
A world without you. Fragmented tail, the eyes will close.
That's dope as hell. Who is that? I don't know. It's an ominous black coat with a lot of zippers.
Something so natural.
Oh, snap. You gotta wonder how much of this they had planned when they made Kingdom Hearts 1. Like, I know this only, like, came out for, like, the final mix and stuff, but, like, still. I remember the first time I saw this actually was when I first beat the final mix version of this game. Like, a couple years ago. I remember, I was like, I've never seen this before. Like, it was just, I was like, what the hell, this is crazy. And obviously I knew what was going on because, you know, I played the other games, but, like, yeah, I was in awe. I was like, god damn, this is a sick-ass cutscene. If I saw this back in the day, god damn. Like, all this, like, I would be so pumped. I can only imagine what people were like, thinking when they saw this thing back in, what, 2002? That's nuts. God, this amps me up so much to play Kingdom Hearts 2. And we're gonna get there eventually, but it's gonna take a while. God, this just looks so beautiful. Like, goddamn. And music is definitely going in its favor, because, like, all of this, man. Damn. I've seen that before, and I'm still like, damn. I guess me.
I went to see him. He looks a lot like you.
I think that's what the line is. Oh, he looks just like you. That's not the line from Kingdom Hearts 2, but it's the line in this, I guess.
Everything is coming back to me, the true.
I don't know who said what, so I just kind of read it. Whew. Is there more? What am I waiting on? There we go. We defeated over 5,000 Heartless. We died 98 times? How? We only died, like, what, 70-something? What? I mean, maybe, I don't know what that extra number would be from. It's really weird. Attacks deflected 1175, times hit by an enemy 2184. Total item usage 105. Party member knockouts 496, of course. Creative spells cast on friend. Zero. Yeah, that's right. I never give a fuck about Donald or Goofy or anybody. But that 98 times defeated, that's...
I'm really wondering why that number is. That's weird. Huh. But yeah, that's the final boss of Kingdom Hearts. Kingdom Hearts 1 Final Mix. And we have the secret bosses left to go, and that's it, guys. I can't believe we're already here. It's, like I said, I've been rambling on for long enough, so I'm gonna end the video here, guys. I hope you liked the video. Please hit that thumbs up button. It would really mean a lot to me. Share the video with the world. And, you know, subscribe if you haven't already for all sorts of different content. I'll make sure that you stay entertained. And until the next video, guys, I've been Meechang, and see ya.